Hello everyone, you're welcome to our channel Learn and Earn Academy, and today in this video we are going to talk about governor's discretionary power. Now, what is discretionary power? Any power which the governor or any person can take on his own willingness, on his own intelligence. Now, using discretionary powers under the constitution, the governor of Rajasthan has returned the proposal of the government to convene a session of the assembly. Now, this is something which the governor can do using his discretionary power. Now, who has the power to summon the house? According to Article 174 of the Constitution, the governor has the power to summon the house from time to time, at such time and place as he thinks fit. But Article 163 states that governor acts on the aid and advice of the cabinet. This article limits any discretionary power of the governor only to the cases where the constitution expressly specifies so. So the meaning of this basic clauses of the constitution is that the governor has the power to summon the house, and he can do that on the advice of the cabinet. Now, cabinet is formed along with the chief minister. The chief minister and the cabinet or ministers who work on the important portfolios along with the chief ministers. So once they advise that the house should be summoned, the governor will issue the orders, right? This is what and how it goes. But this time the governor has used his discretionary power and has said that this time he will not ask for the session of the house. So what is the position of the Supreme Court? Now, as per the law, governor cannot refuse the request of cabinet to call for a sitting of the house for legislative purposes or for the chief minister to prove his majority. Now, this case has gone in the Supreme Court. In Nibam Ribia case, the court observed that the power to summon the house is not solely vested in the governor. As I've already said, the governor acts on the advice of the cabinet ministers, in which chief minister also comes into picture. Now, the Supreme Court has already said that the power to summon the house is not solely vested in the governor. So, governor cannot on his own take this power and decide whether to call or summon the house. And this can be done for two purposes, for lawmaking or for the chief minister to prove his majority. And this time, Rajasthan government is under crisis wherein they are seeking majority, right? So, when a floor test becomes essential. Now, the concept of floor test was first established by the Supreme Court in S.R. Bommaiah case as the only test for determining the majority of the house. And that's quite obvious. How would you determine the majority of a government other than the parliament, other than the legislative assembly, where all the ministers come, right? The court also gave specific instructions about conducting a floor test and the concept of composite floor test in Jagdambika Pal case. In the Uttarakhand case, the court recommended conducting a floor test at as earliest possible opportunity when the majority of the ruling party is in question. So, any time and every time when the government in power is in question, whether they have the majority or not, they have to come in the legislative assembly and prove their majority in front of the government and the people. Now, where can the governor use discretion? Now, this is the most important question. Where actually the governor has the power of discretion? Now, when the chief minister has lost the support of the house and his or her strength is debatable, then the governor has the discretion to summon the house. Okay? A governor can reserve a bill for his consent, for the consent of the president under his discretionary power. So, these are the two discretionary powers which the governor has got. First, if any bill which is not satisfied, he can reserve that bill for the consent of president. The other occasion is when the chief minister has lost the support of the house, and then the governor can decide to summon the house to prove or to allow the chief minister to prove his majority. So this is how it goes. It's a very important video. I'm sure you will all appreciate the knowledge which you must have received from this video.